Welcome, Climate Viewers. My name is Jim Lee from Climate Viewer News. It's April 30th, 2017, and it's that time of year where I ask for your support at climateviewer.com.org and now weathermodificationhistory.com. Every year I ask you guys to support what I do. I don't bug you all year long. I think it's tacky. I don't have ads on any of my stuff. So what I'm doing today is asking you to support not only climateviewer.com, my homepage, you know, where I do all my research, but climateviewer.org, which is looking dead sexy now after 6 years. We've really come a long way. As a lot of you know, I taught myself to code, and this is one of the things that's been birthed from that. Climateviewer 3D is the only place on the internet where you can not only see the satellites in real time, volcanoes, New World Order, Five Eyes surveillance facilities, and earthquakes all on the same map. Pretty awesome. Very unique. The internet's best kept secret, I like to call it. And then over the last year, I was also invited out to Arizona, where I went to Freedom Force International's Third Congress and gave a speech on geoengineering, weather modification, and weaponizing nature. That PowerPoint and video is available right here on the sidebar of climateviewer.com. So I suggest, if you haven't seen that already, you know, the video is 2 hours long. There's still going to be a shorter version of it that's going to be the actual presentation. As soon as I get the DVD, I'm going to be putting that out. But that was an epic event. I'm looking forward to doing more of that in the next year. So with your support, you know, we'll continue to do things like that. Just absolutely amazing experience. And around December, I put out this website, weathermodificationhistory.com. Now, some of you guys have been following me over the years know that, you know, I've had this timeline. At first, it was three separate timelines, one about geoengineering, one about and weather modification, one about HAARP, and one about chemtrails. And then a couple years ago on, you know, when I had resonated.com, then it went to terraformingink.com, and then it went to climateviewer.com. Finally, my timeline went over to climateviewer.org, and it now has briefly it was at theweathereffect.com. Please forgive me. I have to make my mind up about these things, but it finally has a home where it belongs at weathermodificationhistory.com. And I'm doing that with my buddy Dominic Marama, who looks like Dish. And Dominic has been, you know, searching through Google News and old newspapers and doing some graphics work to it and, you know, making them look real pretty. So we've been working together on that. And here's an example of one of his works right here. And you can see, you know, like he takes the newspaper from Google News and then makes it look like the original newspaper. Everything's still there. You can still read it exactly the way it is. And we have the links to the original news, so you can go over and click it, actually see that none of this is fake. You know, it's all original. And we've been hunting down the history of weather modification. So for those who haven't been to weathermodificationhistory.com, this is all the facts, sans the bullshit and fear porn you have to deal with on every other website on the internet that talks about this subject. And I did it for a purpose. It's done for a reason. It's in chronological order. And as of right now on weathermodificationhistory.com, there are 144 entries. Now that's down from 200. Okay. So I thinned it out. It's down to 144, but wait for it. Dominic has about 200 new entries for me to put in this timeline. We're already at 760 references, 52 videos, 162 photos, and 144 entries. And that's me whittling down what I already had from the last 6 years. Now, I personally have about 100 new entries that I need to put into this thing. Dominic has 200. And the problem is that I wrote all this by hand. So this timeline, there was no timeline software on the internet that could hold this many entries to begin with. And to give you an example, just this timeline entry, AMEG Demands Global Geoengineering, when you click on details, you'll see that there are, you know, several pictures and videos. You click on here and then you can flip through them and you can see here's all the photos and then the videos, they automatically play. This is the kind of thing that, you know, we're just stuffing it in there. Everything about this particular subject, all in one spot. You can quickly flip through it. That's, you know, a tiny miracle in and of itself. But everything has a limitation. So even what I wrote, I can't go much further with this without Dominic having to learn to code because I can't keep up with Dominic. He's putting out so much good material on a daily basis. We want to be able to get in there. So part of this donation drive is to purchase a new server because I have written a new version of the timeline, which you can see right here. It's running on my local host. It's not fully functional yet. I'm still working on it. But this one allows us to put 1,000 entries. It's unlimited. I'll never have to worry about a limitation because each article has its own page. And what you'll see is now they look like this. You know, it's got the thing there and the thing and all this, and it's beautiful. That's all I'm going to say about it for now. But this is coming in the very near future. So that Dominic and I can continue to put out, you know, just the facts without our comments and, you know, any of our personal anything. And of course, you can always get that personal anything over here on my YouTube channel. And that's available right here at climateviewer.com. Just come over here, scroll to the bottom, and you'll see my mug about me and the YouTube channel right there. So if you want my commentary, it's all over climateviewer.com and it's on my YouTube channel. Weather modification history is about the material that I'm going to be sending to the senators and the legislators and the lobbyists and everybody I can think of over the next year. So with that being said, I hope that you guys will continue to support me. You've always had my back. I only bug you once a year. My goal this year is $1,000. And that's you know, $300 for the new server, $700 to cover expenses on all three websites, climateviewer.com, climateviewer.org, and weathermodificationhistory.com for the next year. So it's a small price to pay. You guys always got my back, and you know that I'm never going to quit doing this. So love you, mean it, and unless someone like you cares a whole awful lot, nothing's going to get better. It's not.